What's going on, guys? Just Alex here with Angler Support Center, and hoping you guys having a great start of the fall here with this fall bite right now. A lot of things going on out there. A lot of things are working right now for your rock fishing, and we still have a pretty decent amount of fish out there. Not that many big fish, but we still got plenty of fish out there, that's for sure. So let's start off with what's been working up in the upper part of the bay here, north of the bridge, and we're going to be talking about trolling. You know, that's the main thing that a lot of guys kind of switched through the past few weeks here, and it's been producing a good amount of fish for all the boats out there, especially the charter boats out there running. A couple umbrellas, a couple tandems, they've been able to pick up at least all their keeper size fish, a couple unders and overs, and you know, your typical 6-inch shad umbrella like this with a bug skirt, mylar hair, bucktail, any kind of 2-ounce head on there with 6-inch. Now, you know, you can try different colors depending on the water clarity. As you guys know, the colors have always been almost the same for the past few weeks, being your holographic green, chartreuse and white, picking up most of the fish. And I've been also talking to a couple guys that have been doing pretty well with the spoonbrellas still, picking up a mix of blues and rockfish with the spoonbrellas here, especially that white or the ones with the green teasers on them have been producing a good amount of fish. Most of the guys south of the bridge have been pulling mainly spoonbrellas and spoons still because of all the bluefish around. There's not too many of them, but you never know when you're going to encounter them, so that's been one of the tickets there. Most of the guys we've been talking to have been reporting trolling in about 25 to 40 foot of water, and most of the time they're finding those fish closer to the bottom, just 10 to 5 foot off the bottom. So you're going to have to use some heavy weights to get down to that water column where they are. So most of the guys have been kind of pretty much doing that, and also one of the other techniques that people have been talking about in producing fish with has been bottom bouncing. So you know, that's where you keep it closer to the bottom, since those fish are pretty tight to the bottom right now, and that's been producing pretty well for you guys jigging. This is a time of the year when you start seeing birds everywhere. You know, just wait out there and the tide changes, and you most likely you will find some birds. Typical spots like the mouth of the Eastern Bay there by the hill and Poplar Island are typical spots where you'll find breaking fish. Thomas Point, the main channel there by the ships, are going to be spots where you're going to be able to find fish. And a couple of these lures are going to be the better lures to use out there. When you encounter those, you will have to fight through a lot of the smaller ones. But this is the Rain Minnow by GI Jigs. They recommend this green color a lot for your rockfish. Bluefish will still hit that, but apparently that produces a good amount of fish, so definitely check those out. Little bunker spoon, you actually jig this guy a lot different than the rain minnow. It's more of a vertical jig, but that produces a good amount of fish too. And of course, if you're north of the bridge by Luff Point, Swan Point, all those areas, BKDs, guys have been reporting that this exclusive color here, the slimy bunker, has been producing a good amount of fish with your 1/2 ounce and 3/4 ounce jigs. Top water bite has been producing pretty well. Anywhere you have shoreline structure, for example, we were talking about the Tolly's Point around the Severn River, mainly in the morning. Any kind of point or shoal area inside the Severn River has been producing a couple keeper size fish. Mountain Point in the Magathy has been producing fish. Patapsco seems to be the place where everybody kind of has been catching, or we've been getting a lot of reports from. And of course, Eastern Bay around Kent Narrows and all those general areas in Eastern Bay have been producing fish mainly in the mornings or when we have a cloudy day and a cool day. So, you know, try that out for those days. This is one of the favorites right here for this time of the year, and this is a Livingston lure. They make noises as it touches the water, so they make some croaking noises. A lot of guys believe that kind of helps them out, but it also has a glowing tip here on the back side. So if you're fishing at nighttime, you're going to be able to see this a lot better. Some guys recommend it because of the noise. They think it definitely makes a difference, so definitely check those out. And a following bait, which means just something underneath the surface. I personally like this Rapala X-Wrap long cast, which is going to be a little bit heavier lure, so you can make those long distance casts, like, you know, long distance casts And then you're also going to have single inline hooks, which is going to help you when you're catching a lot of fish. You don't have to deal with those treble hooks at all. Just get them in and out. This guy dives to probably about 4 foot of water, so great lure for your, you know, fishing ledges, grass, around grass, edges, or any kind of structure that works pretty good. Now, for you guys down south, trolling has been producing a lot of undersized fish. If you're in that Solomon's, Potomac area, topwater has been pretty good, but not a lot of big fish. Some guys in there are still catching some Spanish mackerel with the trolling spoons, or jigging those metal jigs like I got to show you guys on the birds, but mainly it's been a you know, thing of bluefish and Spanish mackerel around 80 to 72A down there, the target ship and all the middle ground area. A couple guys reported from Crisfield area this past weekend catching a lot of small size speckled trout and a couple of big redfish around Crisfield, all around the, you know, grass areas around Crisfield, Janes Island, and the Pocomoke Sound. So if you're still trying to get out there and get some of those different species down there, make sure you get down there and fish for your trout and some redfish. Gulp mullet, small paddle tails have been working pretty good for that. Going back to the small, you know, perch and spot fishing around this area, your perch are definitely going to be holding deeper now. Bloodworms, any kind of bait on the bottom rig, and you'll find, you know, some perch around the oyster bars, the Bay Bridge pilings, and you might still find some spot. And if you do, make sure you live line them. Since those things are moving out, it's going to be your best bet around the Bay Bridge pilings. So that's it for this week's fishing report. Make sure you send us your pictures, reports. Check us out on Facebook. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. You know, send us all your pictures. We appreciate you guys checking in every week and checking us out. You guys have a good one.